Well, the prize is considerable at the end of this one, and we have only one period left. Seminoles leading the Gators by 3 points. And here we go on third and 11. Werfel has a man, ball almost dropped. It is put away by Rydell Anthony. He's got a big play. He's thrown out of bounds all the way down on the Florida State 43-yard line by Dexter Jackson.
This time he's going to have good protection. Watch the two offensive tackles. Going to keep good protection. The receiver's going to come right into the middle of the field. The two tackles keeping the ends off. He got a lot of room to step up. That's what he's used to having during the season. But this Florida State defensive line has just been dominant.
Jermaine Allen, tight end, did a pretty good job handling Wilson that time, too.
Yeah, he gets getting some help.
43-yard line and working out of the shotgun. Werfel lets it go. It's incomplete over the head of everybody. Ike Hilliard was the receiver in the area. And it'll be second down and 10.
Let me show you, Keith, what they're doing against Bulwer. They're trying to keep Bulwer at home, so they're double teaming him with the tight end and the offensive tackle.
Well, if they can keep doing it, poor Danny might be able to walk to the bus. Elijah Williams, the deep man in the backfield. Second and 10. It's caught. And it's good for a first down by Jacquez Green down at the 26-yard line. Just barely slipped through the arms of the defender.
Look from behind the defense. Five-step drop. Quick pass protection. Just gets in there before Capers makes the play. Chevin Smith saves the touchdown.
It's first down Gators at the Florida State 26. Crowd got kind of quiet there for a minute. Now they come up to help the defense. Pressure coming around. Penalty flag is thrown. Ball is in the end zone. Caught, but hold on. See about the flag. I think you might have a holding call coming. Rydell Anthony threw it. I mean, caught it. As it is holding Florida.
Florida.
Yep, thought so. As Werfel threw the ball, the referee let the flag go, and even though it was right on the numbers to Anthony, it's lost.
That's 79, the right tackle
Mo
on the
Collins.
Play. He got out of the screen. That's not it, I don't think. I think it was up maybe Donnie Young, somebody up there in the line, but he threw it, the official threw it long before Werfel threw the ball.
So they lose a...
We go back to what we said, Keith, before, that the Gators, the most penalized team, about 90 yards, maybe 85 yards a game in penalties. And like you said, it's not the yardage so much, but that took back
a touchdown. Yep. It's a 14-yard penalty. It'll make it first and 24 as he comes back to the 40-yard line. Spot of the foul ball. Had that little short dump off. And they get something out of it as Anthony again. He stepped up. He's got, he lost that last catch, so he would have 8 catches in the ball game. That's a lot.
Well, it was, these numbers haven't changed much. These are mostly offensive numbers from the half, because third quarter was all defense. 9 possessions and 9 punts by both teams. Third down conversions, not very good for either side.
Second down, 11. Again, it goes to Anthony. He makes one little sidestep. That gets him past Colsey, and he gets it inside the 20. These Florida wide receivers are pretty nifty after they catch the ball. Here's Lynch one.
Well, Keith, Rydell Anthony is playing remarkable football when you look at that catch, and consider this. The team doctor just told me he has a slightly separated left shoulder. That's why he came out, but he is still in the ball game, and he's got to be hurt.
Elijah Williams is in the backfield, but he's there more as a protector, probably.
Yep.
Anything else.
Here they come. Look at him.
Oh, no chance. No chance. Dexter Jackson, the free safety, was right up in the crack, and he arrived just about the time that Danny Werfel took his second step.
He got a block down. The offensive line, somebody's got to be responsible for that. That's the problem, Keith, with that aggressive defense where the linebackers are always sticking their nose up in between the defensive linemen. You don't know when to count them and not to.
Here's an effort to tie from 41 yards by Bart Edmiston. He's got enough leg from this distance. He gets it up. No good. Stunning graphic, isn't it? 11 yards. Roughly 18 minutes of the second half. Warrick Dunn is the deep man. He's got the ball coming at him. Oh, he's just missed by somebody. But he's taken down at about the 25. Hey, Lawrence Wright is the guy who just almost cut him in half, but he just missed him. Now, we saw Bart Edmiston limping off the field. And I think right there, that may be where he hurt his foot. Let's go to Swanee.
Yeah, KD, he hurt his knee a little bit, and it's nothing serious. The doctor said he'll be fine, but sometimes, you know, those kickers get a little twinge, and they're not quite sure what it is. So after they go talk to someone to be reassured, Keith.
What are you saying about kickers?
Nothing directly.
That pass completed to Peter Warrick. Once a wide receiver, always a wide receiver. Once a quarterback, always a quarterback.
Once a big ugly, always a big ugly.
Third down and six after a 4-yard pickup. We're all sitting here on a keg of dynamite just waiting for something to happen. I don't believe the final score is going to be 17-14. I just don't.
Well, there's a lot of explosives out there on the field just waiting to be set off.
I mean, there's one guy, one man, 10 yards from the line of scrimmage. Everybody else is right up there. And that's a great throw and catch to Warrick. And there's a first down for Florida State at the Gators' 42-yard line.
Take a look from behind the quarterback. Number four, Wright's the free safety. Look at this open up right in the middle. He throws it right over the center. That's a nice throw and catch. You give the quarterbacks time, they'll hurt you. If you rush them and knock them down all day, they're less likely to hurt you.
First down, Seminoles at the Gator, 42. 10 minutes, 11 seconds to play in the game. Busby back, has time again, and it is incomplete. Pretty good battle for the ball there between the Gators of Florida State. Antone Lott was with him.
Busby says, come on, get the play in here. Get it in there quicker.
Play. Incomplete pass, stopping the clock at 10:03.
Quarterbacks like to get to the line of scrimmage with a lot of time left on that 25-second clock so they can check off if they want to.
Now it's 7 seconds. Snapped it at 6. A soft pass going just over the line of scrimmage to Warrick Dunn. And that's another Seminole first down.
Well, that's dangerous there. You can't cover him one-on-one. It's man-to-man coverage all across the front here. Here's Dunn. He's going to come out of the backfield. He's got a little option. He can go one way or the other. And the linebacker right there has to cover him either way. He chooses to go inside. Busby gets him the ball, and he breaks the tackle.
Johnny Rutledge had to leave the game, the outside linebacking position. Kelsey comes in for Florida. And the Seminoles are moving it from the 27. Here's Busby setting up, going for the corner. And it is incomplete, and no fault of Busby. He threw the ball perfectly. but the intended receiver, E.G. Green, and the defender kind of tangled their feet, and it didn't quite come off.
He had a little trouble coming out of his break. We'll see it here.
Right there.
Yeah, that's no foul there. It's just unfortunate that he stumbled coming out of the move, because the ball was high enough he could have adjusted. Yep. If he would have been there.
That had six all over. 17-14 Florida State. Second down and 10. Ball at the Gator 27. That's the time remaining in the ball game. Little short snap goes to Dunn. Dunn runs it over the right side down to the 20. It'll be third and 3. Alabama is sitting home watching, healing and resting. Florida is going to go to Atlanta. Rouge. Done. He's got the first down. He's close to a touchdown. Out of bounds at the 2-yard line.
Running left side. Good block by Pooh Bear Williams up there. 81 is Pearsall, the tight end. Showers is number 2. He's the free safety. He'll eventually have to get over and make the play.
They give the ball to Williams, the fullback, and he gets his 285 or 6 pounds of rumbling, or maybe a yard, maybe a foot. Warrick Dunn has 168 yards rushing today. He has 4 catches for 24 yards. He has influenced at least 70% of the plays in the ball game that Florida State has run offensively. And he'll probably get it right here on second down and goal from the 1. Well, they give it to the big man, and he does not get in there.
He weighs 285 pounds, Keith, and he was kind of stepping over some people in there. You don't want to be on the bottom of that pile with Boone coming through.
And he'd leave a cleat mark for a month. Here comes Lamar Glenn, the other fullback, into the game. Well, he's going to be in the backfield. Messam has come out. Now Messam is going to go back. Somebody else is going to come out.
Take a timeout here.
Take a timeout. That's what he's going to do. Well, there's somebody waiting to write a ticket for the Florida State Seminoles. It says New Orleans. Maybe they just get up and ride, as Willie calls it, the old city of New Orleans over there. However, this is a chance for him to put it away. They give it to Williams. He does not budge it.
Yes, he did.
He did, too. He fell down.
Second effort.
He wiggled off the top and fell over the side and rolled into the end zone. His first lick, he was stone cold, but he kept on pounding and rolled out and in there.
The defensive effort is solid to begin with. Right there, he's not over. Watch him spins to our right.
Rolls
and he gets
in.
Across, no question.
And Kevin Long, the center, shaken up. And has to come out. Big fella from Somerville, South Carolina.
That'd have hurt him. They don't have any more seasoned backup offensive linemen to put in there.
Here comes your extra point try from Scott Bentley to make it a 10-point lead with 7:15 to play in the ball game, and he's got it. Remember now, a little while ago, Florida lost a touchdown on a holding penalty. Seminoles have come back down, and they have scored. Stoops after Boubert rolled in. ...24-14 for the Florida State Seminoles over the number one ranked Florida Gators. 7:15 remaining to play. The wind grabs the kickoff and it struts very short. Terry Jackson runs under the ball and is returning it to the 40-yard line. Florida Gators come to put up time.
So look at the beating that Werfel has taken today. It's 19-24 out of 37 times he attempted the pass. He's been hit 24 out of 37. That's what Florida State wanted.
That pass deflected at the line of scrimmage, looked like. Incomplete. Greg Spires knocked it down.
Number one scoring offense in the nation. Their possessions in the second half. Florida is averaging 49 points a game.
Over the last 10 years, Florida State has won 7, lost 2, tied 1. Werfel's pass is completed to Ike Hilliard at midfield. And they'll give him possession on the Florida State 49. First down. 6:55 to play in the game.
Spurrier has only beaten the Seminoles twice in the 7 times he has played them while at Florida. And he's never beaten them up here in game in Tallahassee.
Goes to Jackson. And Jackson can't get it going at all. Spires is there. Saunders coming up out of the secondary. Troy Saunders, a cornerback, got a lick on it.
Seminoles protect their home turf pretty well.
It'll be second down, 11 for the Gators.
Here they come.
He got it off. He's got Green. Green can't run it down. Green went inside just a little bit to set up Capers to get away from him, and in the process of coming back, he was not able to run it down. Even with his great speed. Green remembers the young man who had the dislocated hip last year in that final game and made a remarkable recovery.
Florida's not won a non-conference road game under Spurrier because they don't play many non-conference games on the road. They haven't come to Gainesville.
Third and 11 for the Gators at 5:52 and trailing by 10 points.
That was a chance there, Keith. That was a great opportunity. Yep. At time to throw.
Whistles right by the ear of Rydell Anthony, and it is incomplete. That's what a bump can do to you when you're in the bump and run circumstance. It disarmed Anthony. Yep, that was all the bump. That knocks him off track a little bit, and then Darrell Bush, the middle linebacker, got a piece of him. And they're going on fourth down and 11. This might be the game. It might be right here. They're coming. The ball's up. A lot of air under it, and it's incomplete. Ike Hilliard couldn't run it down. One more time, Danny Werfel hits the ground hard.
Theory has been the same. Mickey Andrews put pressure on the quarterback. Blitzing, get all these guys in his face. Now you got one-on-one. Can you hit the deep throw one-on-one? He doesn't have long to wait. He's got to throw it way ahead of time. Just lay it out there and hope the speed catches up to it. Not today.
Whoa, that's a lick.
Gotta throw it soon. That receiver, Keith, is probably only 12 yards downfield when that ball is let go. And he's trying to keep connected, probably 35 yards downfield.
So the man from Alabama, Bobby Bowden, is standing on the edge of something big here with a football team that may very well be on its way to New Orleans. And you figure it's got to be, if Nebraska can beat Texas next Saturday, probably the Cornhuskers. And here comes Dunn. Florida has three timeouts remaining. Florida State obviously is going to try to run the ball, do whatever it takes to keep the clock running.
You look in the background, Steve Spurrier, upper left, threw his clipboard and everything else, because quarterbacks, that's all they ask for, is one-on-one with a receiver that's got some speed. Just give me one-on-one and nobody else back there. And today, they have not been hitting him.
Second down, nine, really. More than eight, but more than eight. Here goes Dunn. He gets another two. Important thing is the clock is running. It is Warrick Dunn running the ball again on third down and long. And he didn't get, in fact, he lost maybe a yard. A little bit of a skirmish breaks out, but the officials handle it quickly and efficiently. And it's going to be fourth down. It is fourth down and seven for the Florida State Seminoles. They lead 24-14. They must punt now. 3 minutes and 56 seconds as the ball is snapped. He gets it away cleanly and knocks it into the end zone. And it'll come out to the 20-yard line, so it's about 2 yards too long. And the Gators will try to come now from their 20, trailing by 10. The decisive drive here, the only drive of the second half by either team, 75-yarder for the touchdown. Bart Edmiston, the University of Florida field goal kicker, right there on crutches with an ice bag on his knee, and that came from kicking the ground after missing a 41-yard field goal try, kicking in frustration.
In frustration. I don't know if he hit the ground or he just kicked the air, Keith, but certainly pulled something in that knee.
And Florida's got 3:47 to go.
They may need a field goal kicker if they hope to tie this game.
Werfel is flushed. And one more time is knocked down. He gets it out to about the 27. It'll be second down and three.
That was probably one of the only times that Werfel has run from the pocket today. And that's what Mickey Andrews and Bowden, the defense for Florida State, knows, that he's not going to scramble outside the pocket. They don't roll out.
Well, the receiver, Jacquez Green, got tangled up in a bump from over there by the defender and was never in the play. So it is now third down and three, and 3:08 to play in the ball game. They've got the first down on this pass to Ike Hilliard up at the 35, 36-yard line. And we're 2:59 to play.
Hilliard looks like he's walking a little lightly there. These are the guys that can take the ball and run a long way, the wide receivers, but Hilliard right there.
He's leaving.
Looks like he's been dinged a little.
It is incomplete. And a penalty flag, and a penalty flag is coming up against Florida State's Mario Edwards, I think. Riddell Anthony had the ball, and it looked like Mario Edwards had grabbed him. Yard penalty and a first down, if that's what it is.
Pass interference, defense, yep. 15 yards, first down.
How many flags is that now? 10 on Florida?
It's 11.
11 flags on Florida State.
Wow. Mickey Andrews, Edwards is a redshirt freshman. That foul was called. He is a backup. Mickey just plays him. He says, I'm playing 8 or 9, 10 defensive backs. I remember his philosophy is, you know, I'll coach next year's team this year. I'll always have some depth. We're just going for a national championship. He plays it.
That ball is thrown high, lofted in the air, and it falls incomplete, intended for Riddell Anthony. They need a little help out there from somebody else. Jamie Richardson needs to get involved and make a play. He hasn't seen the ball. He hasn't been open.
Well, the receiver is going to be in the middle, but he's going to have a lot of time. He's going to be open, but he doesn't have much time to throw. Look, he's got to throw it way early. You got to adjust to that ball. You got to come back to the ball.
Second and 10 from the 49 of Florida State. 2:38 to play, as you see. That's the time remaining in the game. Werther steps away and now is caught behind the line of scrimmage. And it's Renard Wilson this time getting him.
That's the sixth sack of Werther today and the first one for Wilson.
Clock running. Coming up on 2 minutes. Third and 12. Werther throws it hard and has a man. And the play is good for a first down at about the 35-yard line of Florida State. And that will move the chains and stop the clock at 1:51 to play in the game. 24-14. Florida State 10-point lead. Only one touchdown scored in the second half of this ball game. That was for the Seminoles on a 75-yard surge, and that's about all they've done in the second half. It's been
that was
defense.
The only possession that they had.
Defense. Werther throwing for Anthony. He's got it. And he's down at the 3-yard line. He caught it over Mario Edwards.
This is what you've been looking at all day. One-on-one coverage, tight coverage. They've thrown this 15 times and maybe only hit it twice. Not a very high percentage, but they score here. Be some excitement on that kickoff.
A minute and a half to play in the game. Green was held by Samari Rowe. Rowe had his arms all over it. And I'm pretty sure that's what the call is going to be.
Interference, pass interference, defense.
Yep.
First down and a 2-yard line.
Florida did this earlier down in the same position. They must have read something. We're just throwing it out there. And he didn't think that the that's clearly holding. Clearly holding. They just wanted to do that. Throw it out there to the receiver one-on-one. That time.
That cost him 10 seconds.
Yeah, that's true. That's a good point.
And you've got a Seminole coming out. Shake it up. That's Bowler, yeah. I thought he was indestructible.
Maybe he's just run out of gas.
Boy, has he played some football here. Wow. First and goal from the 2. Anthony. touchdown. Riddell Anthony went up higher than anybody else and made the catch.
The Florida State's kicker, Edmiston, is hurt. I wonder, take a look at the touchdown. He was throwing jump balls in the end zone. He's throwing it up there, and their guys are going and getting it.
Matt Teague can do kickoffs. Collins Cooper is a kicker, so he's the sophomore kicker, and Cooper is in.
He hasn't kicked many this year.
No,
either.
He has not. Now's a good time to start your career. There it is. Banged it right up and in.
And he's going to have to be the guy that kicks the tying field goal if
That's
it ever
right.
gets to that point.
That's right. 1:19 to play in the game. We got the Skins game coming up in just a few minutes. Here's a case of a guy just wanted it more than, I guess, than anybody else, because he just went up and got it.
The Gators going into the game thought this would be good down inside the 5-yard line. Just line up one-on-one.
Close. He never quits. He just never stops. He's something. I admire both these teams. They're full of grit, aren't they?
They certainly are.
Whoa.
Just need 1 foot inbound.
If that toe
possession of the ball
is on that chalk, yeah. He's out of bounds.
And the official right there. We had a nice shot of the official looking right at him.
So Teague will kick it off now for Florida. And the Seminoles don't have anybody back there. It's empty back in the, from the 30-yard, 28-yard line on. There's nobody. Because they're anticipating onside kick. Got all of the good hands people up there, and it's open right down the middle of the field. Rock Preston is the only person in the middle of the field. Hit it hard, and did he go through clean? If he went through clean, it'll be Florida State's ball, and there's a penalty flag. Hold on. That could mean just kicking it out of bounds, which is normal. He kicked it hard.
The reason he kicked it hard was
trying to ricochet,
hoping to hit one of the Florida State players.
But he didn't, and it's Florida State football.
Out of bounds. They'll take the ball at the inbound spot, first and 10.
Seminoles did a nice job of getting out of the way. Watch this. Both teams work on this all the time, even though you don't see it very often in a game. They know if it's kicked hard, get the heck out of the way. But this is just good coaching, you know. You work on it from both sides.
All right, 1:19 to play in the ball game. They're probably out walking around the first tee trying to find a television set to watch the finish of the day.
They don't want to start till this is over.
They don't want to start, no. And that's going to be a first down for Warrick Dunn.
Warrick Dunn on the carry.
Florida has two timeouts left.
First down, Warrick Dunn.
One 11. And timeout called by the Florida Gators. They have one left.
Bobby Bowden said earlier in the year, Keith, that his offense was not where he wanted it. When Danny Cannell graduated last year, Thad Busby stepped in, was a little bit inconsistent early on in the year. He's had three games over 300 yards passing, but he said, we got the feeling that they were pointing for the Florida game. We did the Virginia game about midseason, and they defensively and offensively. He said, we're just getting better. He says, we hope to be where we want to be down at the end, and he's there where he wants. He's ahead with about a minute to play.
The Chevrolet most valuable players of the game are Danny Werfel of the Florida Gators with 23 of 48, 362 yards, and he's been hammered on all day. Warrick Dunn influenced the entire ball game offensively for Florida State. 184 yards, he's over 1,000 for the third successive season. 24 yards receiving. They are the Chevrolet most valuable players of this ball game, with Chevrolet donating $1,000 to each school's general scholarship fund. There were a lot of people who could have gone home with that today, but
most of them were defensive players.
Most of them were defensive players, but it's kind of funny that we wind up with the two offensive players, but they were so dominant. The ball is on the 39-yard line of Florida. 1 minute and 4 seconds to play. Florida State 24 and Florida 21. Here it comes.
This was always one of my favorite formations right here. You knew you had the game won, and all you got to do is just take the ball and take a knee.
That gets the clock going. Gators have no more timeouts. That's 50. Well, Ann, you might have to buy him a new suit. You got to go to New Orleans.
And they don't have to play a game before that. They
no,
just
sir.
Sit around and rest up and get ready. Looks like it'll be Nebraska.
Possibly, if they can beat Texas.
If they can beat Texas.
And Florida State. You know what? They look just alike almost. Nebraska is a little more option on the offense, but the defenses play much the same.
Yeah.
It will be a war.
It'll be a defensive struggle. Right?
So the Florida State Seminoles under Bobby Bowden will surely move to number one. And then wait until the Nokia Sugar Bowl in New Orleans for their chance to claim a national championship. And that snap of the ball will do it. Steve Spurrier and these Florida Gators playing for the Southeastern Conference Championship must try to forget their bruises, pump up their pride, and march on Atlanta next Saturday night to play the Alabama Crimson Tide, which we'll have for you at 8 o'clock Eastern Time. Your final score, Florida State 24, Florida 21. Here's Lynn Swan.
Bobby, congratulations. Is this the biggest win for you all time?
No, I ain't gonna say that. I'm not giving Florida that credit.
Okay.
No, it's a mighty big one. It belongs to the kids. I'm got nothing to do with it. All the kids played great. Defense, offense, and kicking. I'm just proud of them.
You win the locker room at halftime. You think you came out. If Florida will let you, you wanted to let Warrick Dunn carry the football.
That's exactly right, and I want us to quit getting penalties. We were in complete charge of this darn ball game, but we got a penalty, and a penalty, and a penalty, and a penalty. And that last touchdown, they got two good penalties.
You also have to have a date in New Orleans.
Yeah, I hope so, brother. Thank you, Lance.
Bobby, congratulations. Keith?
Well, he's something.